About a year. What was that? What was that? What was that? What was that? Greetings, fellow Earthlings. My name is Amber, and we're going to talk. What? Greetings, fellow Earthlings. My name is Amber, and today we're going to talk about why I, the animal loving princess of the forest, decided to quit my job at Petsmart. So, about a year ago, I had posted a vlog about applying for jobs, and I never really said anything about that after. So, long story short, I got a job at Petsmart. And things were really good, and then I quit after like 2.5 months of working there. I don't know why I thought that getting a job at that time was a good idea, because I was going through a lot personally, and I was a senior in high school, it was second semester, I was in a lot of AP classes, I had a full schedule otherwise, I was part of the slam team at my school, and second semester is competition season, and also I was a varsity athlete who competed in a spring sport, so I don't know when I thought I was gonna have time to work or why I thought it was a good idea, but hey, I tried it, and well, yeah. I ended up only working on weekends because it was so stressful for me to try to work during the week with everything going on, and that went okay for a while, but I could tell that my manager was not very happy with me after so long. Yeah, but like in the beginning, obviously, with most jobs, things are slow and you're going through training and orientation and, like, they don't pile a bunch of stuff on you because they don't want to, first of all, scare you away and they don't know how much you can handle and you're still learning and blah, 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 blah. So I would only have, like, one or two dogs an hour at most. Like, sometimes I didn't even have any, and that was fine because the dogs that I did have, I was able to spend a lot of time on and a lot of time with, and I didn't have to kennel dry them, which I absolutely hate. And I don't know, I just really liked that, and that went on for like a month and a half maybe, and I was like, yeah, like this is great, I'll be able to do this, no problem, like I don't know why I was stressed out, this is so fun, and I get to play with dogs all the time, and it was really fun for a month. And then after that slow period, I started getting 4, 5, 6 dogs an hour. That was incredibly unpleasant, and like I have nothing against PetSmart and other grooming like places, but they overbook so often and so much that it's like your dogs aren't in a good environment after a while because they're being taken out of the kennel, thrown in the bathtub, washed really fast, put back in the kennel to kennel dry, which is like, I freaking hate kennel drying dogs. You put them back in the kennel, then you put a blow dryer on the kennel door, so it's just blowing air into the kennel, and these dogs can't go anywhere with air blowing, like, oh my god, I just felt so bad doing that to them, and, like, they obviously were not happy about it, so I would get, you know, as I was saying, like, 4 and 5 dogs an hour, which means every hour on the hour, I was getting 4 or 5 more dogs to take care of, and I would have to wash them, dry them, clean their ears, clip their nails, brush them out, like, brush their teeth, other stuff, depending on what packages the people bought. It just, I was not enjoying it after that point. Like, once I started getting 4 dogs an hour, I was like, okay, like, this is really stressful, because I know that I have to get these done in a timely manner or whatever, because, like, my shift ends or the store closes, and these people are gonna want their dogs dry. After a while of me having my own dogs, the actual groomers that would, like, cut the hair of the dogs, because I was just a bather at that point, but they would ask me to bathe and dry their dogs so that they could get to cutting their hair after they were done with the ones they were working on, so I would have like 7 dogs an hour trying to take care of, and it was just, it was really, really stressful, and like, it was not fun for me. Already then, I was thinking, like, maybe this isn't where I'm supposed to be right now, like, I'm not having fun, this isn't stress relieving anymore, it is stressful. And I think the final straw was with my manager. She's a good lady, like, don't get me wrong, I don't blame her for anything, it was just like, I don't know. I was scheduled on Saturdays and Sundays, and that was my schedule. So on Sundays, I would check my schedule for the following Saturday on when I had to come in, and normally it was either 8 a.m. or 12. I would check it, and sometimes it would say like 9 a.m., and I'd be like, okay, great. So I would show up to the store at 9 a.m., I would clock in, I would go and check the book, and my name would be crossed off, and it would be written under like 12 o'clock. And she would do that often. It wasn't like a one-time thing. Like, she changed my schedule 2 or 3 times and never let me know. So I would show up either late to work or really, really early. And obviously for someone in high school, like, I was trying to plan stuff around my work schedule. So my plans had to get canceled a lot. And I think that happened 2 weeks in a row. And then I was like, you know what? I'm kind of sick of this. That was like the second strike, if you will. And the third thing that happened was I had a poetry slam on Saturday. So this was weeks in advance. I was talking to my manager and I was like, "Hey, so on this date, like I'm probably not going to be able to come into work because I have this speech competition," is how I put it because I didn't want to sound lame. Oh, me in high school. And I told her that I wouldn't be able to come in that Saturday on that date, but I could come in the following Wednesday or the Wednesday before, whatever worked for her. Like, I still could come in, and this was weeks in advance that I was telling her. And she told me that I needed to tell my coach that work was my priority now, and I'm not getting any other Saturdays off. So that was like, okay, what? I don't think you know who I am. Like, obviously, I'm trying to make this work for you. And you're not working with me. Like, I can't, that's not the environment that I want to be in at all. So, yeah, needless to say, I didn't get any other Saturdays off after that one. Again, I don't blame my manager for anything. I know she had a lot going on personally, even though she didn't like talk about it, but like, I could tell. And I don't know, after a while, it just wasn't the right fit for me, so I decided that I was gonna quit because it was just way too stressful and I could fill my time with other things and I didn't need that $100 a week that I was getting. Like, I could definitely live without it at that point. So pretty much when I quit, I called in sick the day before because I actually was sick. I called in sick on a Saturday and I called her on Sunday because she was like, "Okay, just let me know if you're coming in tomorrow, whatever." And I was like, "Okay." So I called her and I was like, "Hey, I can't come in today and I don't think that I'm gonna come in at all after this." And she was like, obviously upset, and she was like, "Well, okay, like whatever." And obviously, you're supposed to put in your 2 weeks and that, but it had just gotten to a point where things were so bad with me personally, and like my anxiety was really bad, and stuff at school, like it was crazy with AP testing and like trying to figure out what college I was gonna go to. I don't know, things, and I was just like, you know, I don't need this, I don't need your recommendation letter, this is not my first job, like I'm okay. So I just called her and I quit, and that was the end of that, pretty much. But since then, things have worked out pretty well. I've continued to work as a lifeguard during summer. I was an assistant manager of a music studio for a while, which was really cool, and then, of no fault of my own, the owner decided to close shop, so I don't work there anymore. But now I babysit for the most amazing children, and that is stress relieving, and it's so much fun, and I love kids and old people. I don't know, things have worked out pretty well since then. So my advice is that if you're in a crappy job, like, leave. Okay? Life is too short to be stuck in crappy situations and unhappy and dreading every morning when you wake up having to go to work. If you really, really need it financially, I kind of understand, but my other advice is to also just trust the universe and know that whatever you need, it's gonna take care of. And if you don't need it, it's not gonna give it to you. So if you don't get something that you think you need, you obviously didn't need it in the first place. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video of me ranting and sharing my experience. If you did, make sure to hit the big thumbs up button down there and make sure to comment and subscribe if you're not already subscribed, and I'll see you guys next week.